Welcome to the Hour of Harvest. It is great to have you with us as we worship the Lord. Sit back and enjoy as we share the good news of the gospel. We invite you to participate along with us as we sing songs of praise, read the Bible, and pray for those in need. The Hour of Harvest prayer team is standing by to take your prayer requests, praise reports, and lead souls to the Lord. You may call us at 606-464-4250 at any time during this program. May this program be a place where you feel accepted, loved, forgiven, and encouraged in the Lord. Hour of Harvest is touching countless souls with the unconditional love of Christ from the Appalachian Mountains to the Bluegrass region, across the nation, and around the world. From our studios in Beattyville, Kentucky, here is your host of the Hour of Harvest, Margaret Drake.
Good evening and welcome into our service. Are you ready to have church with us? Well, we hope you are, because we're here with one thing on our mind, and that is to encourage you in the Lord and give you some good news. The Lord loves you. He hasn't changed. Our world certainly has, but God hasn't changed. He still loves us, and that He wants to be number one in our life. We had a couple of phone calls today here about people in their spiritual condition. One said they have bad lungs, but they don't feel right with the between them and the Lord. And another one called and wanted the Lord to forgive her past and to completely change her life. Well, you know, He can do that. He will. The moment that you are submissive and that you got to believe, you got to believe Him. And so tonight, we know there's a lot facing our world and people, and so many people dying suddenly and everything. So my thought always is, when I hear about sudden deaths, I think, well, was they right with the Lord? Had they prayed? Did they know Him as their personal Savior? Did they get to go home? Well, you know, if you have everything right between you and God, and you know that you're at peace with Him, here's some verses for us tonight. And that is in Psalms 28, 7 and 8. And this is what we can stand on. The Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart trusteth in Him. I am helped. Therefore my heart greatly rejoiceth. With my song will I praise Him. The Lord is their strength, and He is the saving strength of His anointed. And the Lord will give strength unto His people. The Lord will bless His people with peace. And this is the time that we definitely need to see peace in our hearts and in our homes and in the world. We need to see peace. And, you know, we know that the Lord's coming back. We know that things are going to get worse. But we... Sorry. Every time I start saying something, the enemy doesn't want. I'm going to get me a cough drop here. But the Lord doesn't change, so I still want to encourage you. Let's look to Him. If you're saved, then figure out how much that you can pray, what you can do to try to help someone else to get peace in their heart. And as we do that, that's all we can do. We can't save the world. We can't bring them all in. We can't control the weather or anything like that. But we can point them to the one that is God of heaven and earth. And so we can depend on Him to do for us what we need tonight. And so I believe that souls are going to be saved and people find peace in their heart tonight. And that just simply means you turn loose of your selfish will and realize that we were all born in sin.
Yeah.
And we all need to be saved. And so we've all come short of the glory of God. But anyway, He is willing to forgive us and to let go of all of our past. And if we try to hold on to a sinful past, then we're trying to put ourselves above God, because He says He forgets it. So what are you doing trying to hold on to it? So don't do that. Let go. If He's forgiven you, you know it, let it go. And so start as that new person that He's promised you to be. Well, we're believing for victory tonight, and so let's pray as the group comes. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank You and we praise You because You never change. We don't have to worry about picking up the newspaper or turning on the TV or something and hearing that You have changed Your attitude toward us or anything about it. But thank You, Lord, for knowing You are who You are and that You are there for us. And tonight we pray for the salvation of souls, those that are not at peace with You. Let that peace come tonight. Let them find You, because when we pour out our hearts to You, we know You will be there for us. And so bless in the service, bless our guests or phone operators or staff. And Lord, we do ask You to help this world as we see it. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
All right. Tonight we're happy to have the Gloryland Baptist Church from Richmond, Kentucky with us. The phone number is 859-624-3023. And they got a lot of good songs for you. And so just join in. But we want to hear if some of you are really getting peace in your life tonight. Okay. To the service.
Yes, mighty Lord. Sister Margaret, right there where you was at. You know, the Bible teaches me in 1 Corinthians chapter 16, verse 9. Paul said, hey, there's a great door open. Folks, listen to me tonight. There's a great door open for you, and there's an opportunity for you tonight. We've got so many people. Sister Margaret, got a Tanner, has his name out there in Arizona, just come to the Lord. And you know, he's in the hospital, and we ask God, we're going to send him out a song. We're going to send people out a song tonight. Because listen to me, there's a great door open. Sister Margaret, come in and open these doors up. And you know, God is standing there saying, come unto me all ye that labor and heavy laden. I want to give you rest. He's opening up the door of heaven. How many believes that? Amen. I believe we're in a time right now, we're praying for all them people, you know, that's lost loved ones with all that water and stuff going on. And you know, we need, hey, if you're out there tonight, we need to ask God. I'm not going to preach, but I'm going to tell you, we need to ask God to calm the storm. Amen. Amen. He's the only one that can calm it. I feel His presence here tonight because He's here to help us. And you know, Tanner, we're going to send you out this song. It's me again, Lord.
I got a prayer that needs an answer. It's me again. Problem I can't solve. Well, I don't mean to worry you, but here I am facing something new, and I need help that only comes from You. It's me again, Lord.
Well,
I know You're mighty busy in Your heaven.
Pastors out there tonight. Amen. Brother Doug Collins, we're going to send you out a song, and many others that need help. And you know, Sister Margaret, I believe just like yourself, you need people to lift you up. And I believe, honey, that right now we need lifting up more than we ever have. Why? Because He's here, and He loves this song.
Anchored in Jehovah, I shall not be moved.
God is here. And you know what, Sister Margaret? I thank God for you. You didn't let the devil defeat you a while ago. Amen. You just went right on going, right?
Amen.
That's who we need to be.
That's right.
Push on through. Hallelujah. You know, let's do it. Go ahead. God is here.
In childhood I heard of a heaven.
Whoa, have you heard of heaven?
I wondered if it
Sister Margaret, and all we got to do is walk in and say, Lord, listen to me. There's people out there tonight. Say, Lord, forgive me of where I failed you. Forgive me of my sins, Lord. Enter my heart. Save me, Lord. You know, today, me and Sister Margaret talking about COVID, how it messed everything up. But it's gone, folks. And Jesus is standing there with open arms. He's saying the door's open. And there's adversaries are stopping us. What's stopping you tonight from coming to the Lord and getting the joy that we need? How many like to have it? I'm having a ball tonight.
Yeah.
What about you, Gary? Come on, put a smile on you. We're having a ball. Glory to God. There you go, Tony. What about Rod? Oh, yeah. That wasn't too cool. This thing is so real and so alive that I don't want to, hey, there's no way I'm going to spend eternity in hell.
No.
Because, hey, there's no spirit there. There's no light there. There's no comfort in there. All there is torment. Oh, Lord. There's people today, folks, he tells me in the Bible about the days of Noah. Real plainly, I want to be there, don't you? Amen. Folks, that door's open to everybody out there. What would hinder you from crying out to the Lord? Call in tonight. You got children lost. You got, people out there. We've led a lot of them to the Lord lately. But one thing about it, we can't save them. But we can, show them the way.
That's right.
And the way is. He's that way, honey. He's standing today. I'm not preaching. I'm just trying to get America to wake up and realize that this thing is real.
Amen.
Hey, you see signs. Floods coming everywhere. Yeah. Fires. Chemical places burning. Folks, if you ever prayed, now's the time to pray.
Yes,
telethon coming up.
Yep.
Hey, they ain't had no electric here. I think it come on today. You know, telethon's coming up. If you got something to give, give it.
Yes.
Hey, let the door be open to you. Amen.
Yes, amen.
I can feel that door being opened. And you know, gonna sing Kathy and Libro out a song.
Going home to Jesus. In the twinkling of an eye, I've made my reservation for a mansion in the sky. Well, it may not be the moment, and it may not be the day, but I know that I'll be leaving when he calls his church away. I'm listening for the trumpet to sound most any time. Thank God will soon be mine. I have got my invitation.
People, Sister Marks called me lately. Blood pressure's up and down. I hope mine's not. Don't look like I got blood pressure. No. But we're going to pray for them. And Murray's one of them. That we're going to pray. That I believe God can. I believe He's able. Amen. We walked through that door. He said, ask, and you shall receive. You've heard His words, but I'm going to repeat them again. Where there's two or three, He's in the midst of it. Roger, I believe He means business. I believe He means business today. Amen. He's standing there. Well, preacher, I don't feel Him. Well, I'll tell you what. Go to praying. Oh, Father in heaven, hallowed be Thy name. Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done. You know, if you don't know how to pray, a lot of people don't know how to pray. But one thing about it, just look up and say, Lord, help me pray.
Yes.
Hey, give me that blessing. And I believe He'll pour it down upon you. But we're going to sing and send them out a song that's got blood pressure problems. Anybody here got it? Oh, back there's one. You know, hey, I'm a believer in this stuff.
Yes.
How about it, Glenn? Are we believers?
Yes.
We're believers. Well, what kind of song are we going to sing for the blood pressure? Maybe? I am blessed. I am blessed. God's here.
Yes, he is.
He's helping us. And you know what? The door is still open.
Amen.
I've had some people, well, this got in the way, that got in the way. Folks, don't let nothing keep you out of heaven.
That's right.
I'm telling you, it's real. You can see it happening today. There's signs here on earth, and there's signs in heaven. But one thing about it, Hey, call upon him before it's too late. Call in. There's people up here would love to lead you to the Lord.
Yes.
I would talk to you about it. If not, you can call my number, honey. We'll get to the Lord. Yes. We'll pray through this thing.
Right.
We need to pray through it, don't we?
Yeah.
Amen? Oh, I'm going to pray for my cowboy buddies. And Sean, we're praying for you. He's getting better, Sister Margaret. He's back running again. So, hey, there's power in prayer.
Yes, there is.
Anybody with me?
Amen.
Anybody called? There's power in prayer.
Yes.
I know. Glory to God. You guys can work with me. Lord's with you. Amen. Because he... Woo! See the bright light shine.
Hey. It's just about home time.
Woo! Yes.
I can see my Father standing at the door. This world is a wilderness. I'm ready for deliverance. Lord, I've never been this homesick before.
There's a light in the window. Table spread in splendor. Someone standing by an open door. I can see the crystal
Look out that river. Doctors, because they're getting to her like this. Mm-hmm. Poor preachers dragging themselves in.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not making fun. I just see it happening.
Yeah.
You know. But one thing about it, I want to stay energized with the power of a living God.
Amen.
How many believe he's alive? Amen. How many believe God not dead?
He's still alive.
Oh, my
God's not dead. He's still alive.
Morning.
He's still alive. He woke me up this
to feel him. It gets exciting, doesn't it? Somebody said, what are you on, honey? I feel I'm on that spirit of a living God. And people praying the prayers. Amen?
Amen.
I believe we can lift one another up. How many believes we can?
Yes.
You can do better than that. Come on. God's so good. And you know, this song, we're going to lift up to the elders. My sister, Loranda's mother, Beulah, all of them in the nursing homes.
Yes, Lord.
A lot of them's got connections. A lot of them don't. Well, one thing about it, we've been leading a lot of people, Sister Mike, to the Lord from the nursing home.
Yes, Lord.
And you know, tonight, it seems a little special tonight that you give me that scripture. Let him open up them doors. He's the door. He said, I'm opening.
Yeah.
I'm knocking. Just let me in. Let me in. I want to let him in tonight and say, Lord, hey, you're on time. And we love you and we trust in you. How many really trust in him tonight?
Amen.
Give a call.
Yes.
Help his station. You know, because this station is an open door.
Yes, it is.
We walk in. You know what? We don't have to pay for singing and bringing you the good news of Jesus.
Right.
But one thing about it, he's
amen.
Here. I feel him here, don't you?
Amen.
How many's with me?
Yes, amen.
Huh? We may be tired, overloaded. Hair may be in our eyes. Eyebrows too long. I don't know. But anyway, he's here to help us. How many believes that? Come on. He's there. Call him up.
Call him up. Tell him what you want. Call him up.
Call him up.
Call him up. Tell him what you want. Call him up. Call him up. Tell him what you want. Tell him what you want right now. Tell him what you want. Jesus on the main line. Tell him what you want. Jesus on the main line. Tell him what you want. Tell
Send you out this song, okay? It ain't delivered to you. Hey!
Amen.
quieting down.
All right. Well, that's some good lively songs to perk people up. So if you'd like to get in touch with them, 859-624-3023. We have a number of requests here, and here's Mary has called from Moorhead and said, for the family of Troy, he was hit and killed on the interstate while loading a vehicle.
Bless him, Lord. Bless that
and,
family.
Yeah, that's a...
Yes, mighty God.
And the Alderman family from Lexington, it says to pray for the mom. The father died only in September the 18th, and now his mom is back in the hospital, not doing well, and they want prayers for his mom to be would be appreciated.
Bless him, Lord.
And that's from Lexington. From Rockhold, Monica has called for her mom and dad. She worries about their health, and she knows the Lord is always keeping his hand
Thank
on them.
Thank you, Lord.
So that was good, and. All right, right quick, let's share these and then see what else is. Judy from Pikeville said she loves WLJC and Gloryland Singers, and they need prayer. Enjoyed the program. This is from Silas from McGolfin County. He's in a nursing home, and he says he is moving to Pennsylvania. Well, we trust that will be a good
yes.
mood for you. Judy loved the singing and pray for her. Linda from Morgan for her boys. Martha from Moorhead had surgery yesterday, got COVID and is in intensive care, and a daughter has heart problems and about the flood. Jeremy from Lexington for his girlfriend. Thelma from Madison for her big family. McGolfin County, Mary has called for her husband, Earl.
Is very sick.
They're very sick, has been there for 9 days and still sick. And Flemingsburg, Nancy for herself. Joyce has called for Michael Barnes. He's in the nursing home, going to have a scope on his throat. Wilma for Troy had a stroke and can't see in one eye. Oscar from Williamsburg, grandson, needs salvation. Terry from Menifee for himself. Vicky from Breathitt, several doctor's appointment, and this was from Charles from Morgan for a number of people
Thank you, Lord.
That need prayer. And all right, we have Wilma. Lady has called for her. She's still in the hospital from Whitley County. Faye for herself, Troy, for all that are that has been affected by the hurricane. All right, that's an awful lot of people. And we have another one here, has panic attacks and wants the Lord to be more real to
yeah.
her. And so that's, I'm going
to... Ain't that good, Sister Margaret?
Yes, it is.
Want the Lord to be more real?
Yes,
I
yes,
like that,
yes,
don't you?
Yes.
We need that real God, don't we? Just like
yes.
you had a while ago when he's trying to, that the adversary trying to get, hey, I yeah. love that. Breakthrough! Yeah.
The Mullins family from Breathitt, they're praying for our telethon. Thank
yes.
you so much. Betty Young from Perry County, $25, and has watched us for a long time with
Lord.
Her mother. Thank you. That's for the telethon. And she's enjoyed the service. It's been uplifting for her tonight. And there's an empty sheet. And... Okay, Mary from Montgomery County, Edgar, her husband passed away.
Bless her, Lord.
She needs strength. All right, this is a someone that needs prayer. Alberta from Morgan, for prayers to be answered, blessings given, it says. All right, well, he does that on
yes,
a daily
does,
basis. Daily basis. It's so... Okay, from Laurel County, for a family that their children was raised in church and needs a touch now. Janet from Fayette enjoyed the music. Betty from Morgan, heart problems. All right, there's who all has called tonight, and I'm sure a lot of her folks still don't have electricity and phones and everything back, and so...
Sister Margaret, you know, I believe, and hear me, I believe stress, it causes a lot of issues, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, stress is really getting people, you know, hey, you go in, used to be, I went in the store, you know those little bags of donuts? Mm-hmm. They used to buy them for 99 cents or $3 now. I said, wow.
What's you didn't need them donuts.
But I mean, you know, this thing got out of hand on us, ain't it?
Amen.
Go ahead, Tony Jefferson.
Well, I want to shout out to my friend Ken at the CR at Indian Hills. And speaking of Indian Hills, Celebrate Recovery in Danville, Kentucky, they're having a night of celebration.
Come on.
With a Cross Point worship on Friday, October the 18th at 7 p.m. They are, if you don't know where Indian Hills is in Danville, they're next to the bowling alley across from Save-A-Lot. So they're going and having a night of celebration, celebrating your recovery. We have Celebrate Recovery at Cecil's Church, Gloryland Baptist Church. If you guys don't know where Gloryland is, it's halfway between Berea and Richmond across from the dollar store there. And come out and be with us on Thursday night.
Yes.
We have a meal at 6 o'clock, and we have a small group at 7:30, and our large group at 7:30, and small group at or 6:30, we have large group. 7:30, we have a small group. I'll get that straight in a minute. But come out if you have a hurt, habit, or hang up. Basically, sin is addictive, so we
come
all
on.
Have a sin
Amen.
Problem.
Amen. That's right.
And we all need to be in recovery from our sin problem. So I'll be glad to see you there.
Mm-hmm. I just believe Gloryland's rehabilitation.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. All of us got problems. You know, I don't care what your hair looks like, your clothes look like. Hey, we all got issues. How many out there don't get issues? Call in right now and tell them. We're going to ask God to. We're going to ask God. You know, I love yous all out there. I get a lot of calls from different states. But you know what? The only one can answer that. I tell you and lead you away just like Sister Margaret does or Tony. But one thing about it, God has to intervene. Mm-hmm. That Spirit of God is what we're looking for. And I forgot to sing somebody that song tonight, Sister Margaret, all in the upper chamber. But maybe we'll get it the next time. Lord, we're going to anoint these with oil. We're going to cry out on your mighty name because you're always there. And Lord, we ask you to bless every prayer request here. Put your hands towards that TV and let's cry out to God for our country. Lord, this is a country that you blessed it and blessed Jerusalem, Lord. I just cry out for Jerusalem because your hand is on it, Lord. Them's your people and we're your people here at WLJC, Lord. We cry out for Sister Margaret and his staff. I know it's going to go on because you opened the door for us, Lord. I feel that door being opened and I know you're there for us. And we cry out for those ones sick in the hospital, Lord. And oh, glory to God. And my family and children and grandkids, we got a lot of them out there, Lord. Please protect them. We cry out one more time to you. Open the door for them and we'll never fail to ask you to bless this telethon in Jesus' holy name. Through your Spirit we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Yes, yes. All right, we do want to remind you that the 21st we will be starting our telethon. So I noticed in one of the recent letters someone sent an offering and said they wanted to get theirs in early.
Amen.
So they could listen to the music. So that's good. Sometimes that happens. But we really appreciate your help. Like we've talked before, the COVID sure did a number on everybody,
yes,
including the ones that supported the ministry. So many of them went on home during after that. But, you know, God didn't. He's still right.
That's right.
He's still right there. And
Amen.
So, and he still knows our needs. And,
yes, he does.
And he's still answering that. So, but we appreciate all of you that are praying and looking for ways that you can help. So anything else?
I just thank God, Sister Mark, for the ones that put up with me and helped me bring this message. And we bring it in many states. Mm-hmm. And I thank God that they'll put up with me. You know, we got once in a while, we just got to brag on one another, don't we? Because I brag on you, because you got these kept these doors open, and I praise God for it. You know, there's more to it than preaching and singing.
Yeah.
It's just looking to Jesus, the author,
yes,
and the finisher of
yes,
faith.
Amen. Yes, yes.
Amen. And you can, if you need help, if you need help finding a rehab, or if you're
That's
struggling,
good.
Reach out to me. Our phone number is 859-661-2134. Again, it's 859-661-2134. And just want to thank Margaret for getting out the word.
Yes, Lord.
Here, that's the most important thing we can do is get out the word.
Yes.
And I believe WLGC does that.
Yeah.
You know, Tony, one thing about Tony, Sister Margaret, when he refers someone to a place, mm-hmm. it don't cost him nothing. That's what
oh,
it
okay.
is. Praise
good.
God for that.
Oh, yes. And so, yes, there's so many suffering from that. It's just another way for the one of those doors to be open
yeah.
that you mentioned to get some help. And so we appreciate all the effort that they're putting forth. Well, it looks like that we're running out of time. So from all of us, we want to say good night and God bless you.
God bless you.
Thank you for being part of the Hour of Harvest. We hope that you are truly blessed and encouraged every time you watch. This program is made possible by your contribution and support. Would you become a financial partner of the Hour of Harvest with a one-time or monthly offering? You can send your pledges of support to the Hour of Harvest, Post Office Box Y, Beattyville, Kentucky, 41311, or visit us online at www.hourofharvest.com. We also accept Venmo and PayPal. Just scan the QR codes to donate. May God bless you.
so